Listen, even in everything, before we got here with Peter being married to Amina, you have to keep in mind, again, I wanted him to manage her. I liked her.
That's what's crazy about it.
I was like, oh, you know, like, I.
Did you, like, bump her music in the crib while cleaning up the crib on Saturdays?
I didn't bump it, but I'd be like, hey, let me hear the song that Amina, the video she just recorded. Like, let me hear it again. Like, play it. Boom, I got the boyfriend. I got the man. Boom, I got
the boyfriend. I got the man. Oh. Hey, this is Tara Wallace from Love & Hip Hop, and you are watching ThisIs50.com.
I've been drinking. I get filthy when that liquor get it to me. I've been thinking. Why can't I keep my fingers?
Okay, well, this is 50.com. You guys interrupted a little bit of girl talk, but I am chilling with Tarnasha Wallace. I say Tarnasha because that's your name.
That's not what you say. You say Tarshanae Chanel.
Your whole name. You might not want to get that to this crowd. They have your social security number and your debit card information in 15 seconds.
Like, that could stop me. Once I got her account number, I couldn't spend fast enough.
From Love & Hip Hop, New York, Tara Wallace. Chilling here with me, this is 50.com. How are you, love?
I'm well. Thank you for having me.
Of course.
I don't take for granted that just because you're my friend, you're going to have me on your show or interview me.
Well, no.
So, thank you.
But you're like the crowd favorite, so I have to anyways, not just because I love you. Like, how's it feel being on this show and like this whole having your life like play out on this show?
Listen, I take it like I do everything else. Like, okay. You know, the one thing that I say is, if something, whatever hits you, you just have to deal with it. So when the blows started coming, I just started dealing with it. I didn't know that I was going to be here dealing with this, or, you know, while the show was, you know, while they were filming these things that were happening. So I tell people, like, when you find out something, that's when I found it out. You know what I mean?
A lot of people ask, like, is it real? Like, and it's 1,000%, like, real, correct?
It's 1,000% real. I'm waiting for, you know, someone to jump out and be like, ah, we got you.
You're okay to camera.
Yeah, I'm waiting for that moment. It's just, it hasn't happened yet. So that's kind of freaking me out.
All right. There was this thing on the blog that, like, made me crazy. They said that this was all fake because you are a trained actress. Now, just give the people a little bit of your acting background or your background. You're
as
trained.
An actress.
Like, you went to school for this.
Yeah, I have an MFA in acting. I studied acting, speech and theater in undergrad 4 years. At Jackson State. So student loans later have an MFA.
Yeah. So she's educated, but that does not mean that it played. This is your real life, though.
You know, it. Listen, when it comes to, let's just relate acting in terms of reality TV. For me,
okay,
it was me just trying to be relaxed before every scene, so that I can respond to the information that I'm receiving.
Okay.
I do not have the talent to create something so crazy.
Exactly.
You know, even in my most artistic moment, no.
You actually talk to your fans on social media. You're on Instagram and on Twitter. And, like, and sometimes it's like you're, like, snarky like me. Or, like, you're like, just God bless. But what is the, like, biggest misconception? Or if you could, like, just say to people, answer one big question or one big thing that they all have wrong, what would it be?
You know, that I'm the type of woman, I guess, that would just lay down and take anything. You know what I mean? People are like, well if he's done this before, and well, he's done this several times to you. I'm like, no, we were here before. I forgave an infidelity. Yes, we were working on that.
And then he did it again.
And then
I'd say,
we're here
again. Raise your hand if you ain't played a fool for a man.
I mean,
especially
listen,
if he, nothing, never
you know,
mind.
Women, we fall in love. We love hard. It's different. We give our all. And you know, there's no regret in that. It's just that you hope that other people on the opposite end, on the receiving end of that, will grow up.
Will reciprocate.
And reciprocate and respond a little bit differently and more in the favor of the relationship.
What is you and Peter's relationship right now?
Right now, I'm just trying to keep from going to Rikers.
Okay. All right. I got bail money for you, boo.
Okay.
Call me up. Text me.
You know what? I say this all the time. As women, and when you have children, you have to eat a big piece of the humble pie.
Absolutely.
It never stops. You always are the one always forgiving, always overlooking for the sake of the kids. It's crazy. Like, if I were to just react to everything Peter did, or if I, you know, just be, if I'm angry all the time, you know, we would never accomplish anything. We would just continue to fight because he'd be defensive
all the time.
For whatever he's trying to defend.
Okay.
But he would be defensive all the time. And, you know, you just have to, for me, find a balance going into my core. You know,
okay.
Remember who I really am and moving forward. And then from there saying, okay, this has happened. Now, where do we go from here for our children?
A lot of people champion the moment where you slap the shit out of Amina.
Nothing fake about that.
you, in hindsight, like, feel like you shouldn't have done that, or like you should have cocked back to Africa and mollywopped the shit out of her a little harder? I'm sorry. Can you tell, know, I'm not biased?
You just make
that up. Yes, I did. On the spot.
I don't condone violence. Listen, I have 8 brothers, so I'm very physical.
Okay.
But it'll be like, oh, stop being so silly. You know what I mean? It's not.
That wasn't like that, though.
It wasn't like that. No. That took me out of my character, so I'm not proud of that moment. However, do I wish I had not done it? I can't say that. I can't say that I wish I hadn't reached back to Africa a little bit further. But I don't condone violence. Okay. It's not okay to hit someone.
But in that moment, she...
But then, for the way that was delivered, if you didn't want that to happen, you should have found a better way to deliver it.
I'm his wife. And ain't nothing fake about that.
You know, come to the table with, listen, we got to talk because he has done some crazy things and I have something to talk to you about that you are not going to believe.
Do you
now,
think...
let me show you that he loves me. No, I have something that this could be hurtful to you. Like...
So do you think that she handled the situation differently, that it would have been a different outcome?
Oh, absolutely. If she had handled it differently, I would have handled it differently.
Okay.
If she sat down at that table and said, listen, you know.
Been a little more humble about it.
A little bit more humble. And it just let me know that her intentions were to let me know what was going on. And from that moment, she just did not care. That was her super objective. Mm-hmm. And the idea was already planted. You see? If she had to go through her purse and fumble for.
But it was in her bra.
It was ready to go.
Yeah.
Like that. And that scene was gonna end like that, no matter what.
Okay. Yeah. When you watch back on the interviews and when you watch back their relationship with each other and the things that she says, like, I have to let Tala know that. How does that make you feel?
To see Peter be intimate with any woman, obviously bothers me.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you have to keep in mind that this is a man that I loved. And I said,
and then he would come home to you after those scenes were filmed.
A lot of those scenes were being filmed, yeah, he would still come home. You know, it wouldn't be happy when he got there, but, you know, because I was still dealing with the fact that not seeing yet what was to come, but dealing with the core, which was he had married her.
We woke up in a kitchen